trying to chalk this up as one of those nights, not just for Luke, but pretty much everybody.
Yeah, it was a bad night all the way around when, you know, our defense, our energy, and then the turnovers hurt us. It's hard when you turn it over and in transition. You give up, you know, that many fast break points. It's hard to guard. Give New Orleans credit. They came out and they played hard. I thought we took their first punch there in the first. It was 30 to 26. They make a half-court shot. It's 33 to 26. And, you know, you're in the game and you didn't play well in that first, but it just was a domino effect from there.
I think it was the floor in the uniforms. We just didn't see them.
Well, I'm joking. 17 steals. You got to give them credit. They were good defensively. They were good.
Well, I mean, you brought up the floor jokingly, but... You know,
I was just joking. That's just trying to make light of it. This is just one game. The players are playing. Honestly, that's a question for them. I think that the floors are hard to watch on TV. And so the league has gone a little bit too far with the floors. The uniforms I get, but the floor is maybe a year or two from now. And we've had problems with the floor. But it's too late. There's nothing about the floor tonight. We're not using the floor as an excuse, so just make sure we're not quoted on saying the floor is a reason why we lost. Turnovers, and give credit to New Orleans coming out and playing hard.
One of these, maybe it's probably a good thing that you got one coming in about 20 hours.
Yeah, this is the great thing about the league. We move forward. We'll learn from this. We got to take care of the ball. We got the Wizards tomorrow. You know, this is not an ideal back-to-back, but we've been through the back-to-backs of home and in Orlando. Now we go from New Orleans to D.C., so we got to prepare for them.
New Orleans was aggressive with ball pressure and then, like, rotating the movement to pack the paint. Were those some of the key things that kind of, you know, caused some of those turnovers and made things challenging the backcourt?
Yeah, they did the same thing they did the other night. We just got lucky with some of the passes, and then also being able to, we didn't just turn it over at half court. Tonight they packed the paint. We didn't shoot the three as well as we have here in the past. So we'll go back and look. And then, again, we got to take care of the ball. I mean, we got to get looks. We just didn't get the looks tonight.
What can you point to as the biggest reason such an about face for 48 hours ago?
Turnovers. That's all I can say. Turn over the ball too many times. They got transition points. That's the difference right there. They didn't do anything special. Just had us turn the ball over. They capitalized on it, and they made their shots.
Good night ahead. Another one coming in about 20
hours. Yeah. Also losing an hour as well. So we got to get out of here. We know we got to we thought this team was running fast. We got another track meet tomorrow. So we got to be prepared and ready for them.
Dan, what was the state of your face?
He does a great job, man. He does a great job of disrupting any offense in the league. Obviously, I think he was a huge difference maker out there. I think he gives a lot of the other guys out there on the floor a lot of confidence, knowing that he's out there, knowing that he could read and react and have their backs when there's a mistake or if there's a miscue on that end of the floor defensively. So, you got to give him credit. He does an amazing job to disrupting a lot of action.
Both teams are playing on the same conditions, but I have to ask you, as a player, is it hard to get adjusted to the college teams so differently?
I mean, it doesn't matter what I say. It doesn't matter. They're going to do whatever they want at the end of the day. So court, outdoor court, windy conditions, doesn't matter. Basketball is basketball.
What do you attribute to the pretty fast turnaround, 48 hours between that game and
yourself? Yeah, they came out with way more intensity. We expected that, and we didn't respond, you know. You knew after a game like that, the team's always going to respond in a tougher, more physical way, and they also played just harder than us. We came out and we had, gave up 30 fast break points in the first half. It's got to be unacceptable for us, you know. It's one of those things where you got to look each other in the eye and challenge one another, and we didn't do that tonight. We just allowed it to keep happening. Even in the start of the third, that's when you're supposed to, you know, we've shown that we can fight through adversity, and that we just didn't do that this quarter, this time.
That it didn't happen, that you didn't fight through adversity. How shocking is that to you?
You know, it happens over the course of a season, but you can't let it be recurring. You know, we've had two or three games, the three losses that we've had, they're uncharacteristic of us. You know, like we have a game where we, you know, don't do our job and rebound endeavor. And that game that we lost to Toronto, they were just more physical and out-toughed us. And this game, they played faster than us and they played with a little bit more edge. They were just playing in the passing lanes, gambling, because, you know, as we know, that team is very athletic. They do a great job of getting out in transition. It's hard. They're hard to beat when they do that. Keep them in the half court, you might have a better chance, but we didn't do that tonight. He reminds me, him and Dijon are very similar. They are very unscreenable, very great length, great size, being able to not only maneuver off and on ball, difficult to screen. Herb does a phenomenal job. He's continuing to improve. He's a guy that, you know, I've always respected since his days at Alabama. He's going to continue to be an elite defender in this league. And for us, we just got to do a better job of getting our players, you know, better opportunity if we're playing against a guy like that. And they did a different, you know, game plan, putting him on the screener, putting him on Lively, so that way we don't get the rolls behind on Vooch, or not Vooch, Valanciunas. And we try to, you know, attack Val, and they did a good job of Channel 5 and whatever you want to call it, blitzing us and making Luka and them get off the ball. And we got to do a better job of on that backside and being more present and giving those guys outlets.
How concerned are you defensively?
I'm not super concerned, just because of the fact that I know where this potential of the defense can be. You know, we've shown it. It's just that we are very inconsistent with it, and we have to make a commitment because our offense is, you know, impeccable. We've done a good job of playing with pace and really diving in on that end, but our biggest strength can be our biggest weakness sometimes. You know, being able to understand, yes, our offense can definitely win us games, but at the end of the day, we have to tone our tone, bring our hard cap on and guard somebody. And that's going to be the next step of this team. You know, we have the ability. It's just whether or not we choose to do it.
We could obviously have one of those nights happen, but they seem to have to plan for it. They got out of hand about 18 to 20 hours
ago. Yeah, it happens. You know, and when you put all the pressure that we do on him, the superstar, you know, you're bound to have a game like this, and we're supposed to support him. You know, in a game like tonight, as the group that's around him, we have to do a better job of making sure that, you know, in those situations where he's getting pressured or feels like he needs to, you know, get him a better opportunity, better looks, getting him off the ball, you know, so that way he doesn't have to force things or try and make plays, you know. And I feel like tonight, you know, it's not trying to excuse the play, but our job is to pick him up in situations like this, and we didn't do that tonight. So we'll definitely challenge him. You know, it can't happen. I think in our three losses, thus the biggest thing that's been our kryptonite is our turnovers mainly. And so we have to address that and understand that when we take care of the ball, we're a very hard team to beat.
It's the second time you play
on one of these courts. Yeah, I think that the courts, you know, have potential. You know, it's the first year. You know, you're bound to have hiccups. They're bound to have inconsistencies, and you know, it's a new court, so you know, got to break them in. It's the first time anybody's playing on them, so it's definitely one of those things that has potential and, you know, can have success in the future. It's just a matter of execution. You know, I keep saying my biggest feeling should be that it should be hardwood with like the offset tone in the center of the court, still with the trophy. I think that'd be a great look for the league, and especially since it still brings attention to the trophy around, and then you can maybe add more accents across the court, like, and more like how we have the silhouette of Dirk on our court. You do more of that, more so than you do like the full color of the court, because even, you know, when we first got on the court yesterday, you could tell the three-point line was a little bit off, like just from the panel, like you could tell like it was like a little bit separated. And so like we just have to, you know, address that, and I feel like there's potential for this season, like in season tournament going forward, and I think that we got a lot of not only opportunity there, so we just got to take full advantage of it.